ever wonder where exactly did the periodic table come from? Well, we can thank the French nobleman Lavoisier. He was the one who basically is known as the father of modern chemistry. He basically helped to predict the names of oxygen and hydrogen and successfully predicted the element silicon. He was great when it came to stuttering patterns in chemistry as well as biology, and it's because of him that we're able to construct a list of the first 23 elements that would eventually lead to the periodic table. Now, it wasn't until 1869 when we had Mendeleev who used the word periodic table for the first time. He saw patterns in these elements. He saw that they increased in mass over time, and then he saw that their electrons arranged themselves in certain patterns which caused them to have similar chemical properties. We'll get more into this type of periodic law as well as electrons later on in the semester. But just realize it's because of these two great scientists that we have the periodic table. Today we have well over 110 elements in the periodic table, 114 and counting. We're going to say that a majority of them occur naturally in our environment, and there are some that we've even synthesized in the laboratories. Now, if we take a look at the periodic table, you're going to have to realize that when it comes to the periodic table, you're going to have to memorize a few of these elements. Most professors will want you to memorize the first 30 elements. But honestly, to be entirely safe, I would recommend memorizing elements 1 through 36. Now, when I say memorize, I don't mean memorize the symbol and all the numbers associated with it. That'll come over time through practice of problems. What I say by memorize, I mean realize that when I see Ni, what element is that? That's nickel. This would be titanium, magnesium. Memorizing the first 36 symbols will help you in a long way to figure out what exact element are we talking about when you're given a symbol. Now, we have to realize that the periodic table, because of the periodic law given to us by Mendeleev, is set up this way because it follows their reactivity and chemical properties. We don't need to know exactly what those are yet, but just realize that the periodic table is set up this way for a very good reason, because this is the way their electrons arrange themselves. But what we need to know right now is exactly what do certain areas of the periodic table tell us. Now, what we should realize is that there are basically three types of groups in the periodic table. There are metals, there are metalloids, and then there are nonmetals. Now, here when we go to B, B is called boron. And what we're going to do here is we're going to draw a staircase. So here goes our staircase. Now, we're going to say on this staircase, there's boron, there's this silicon, there's arsenic, there's Te and At. These five elements that are on the staircase. Right underneath the staircase are these two, germanium and antimony, Sb. These seven elements that I've highlighted with these blue streaks, these are our metalloids. Metalloids are called semiconductors. What exactly does that mean? Well, semiconductors means that they conduct electricity. You can run electricity through them. Not as well as metals, but much better than nonmetals. Metalloids are basically a blending of nonmetals and metals. They don't exactly fit in metal category or nonmetal category. What they are kind of like a hybrid of the two. Metalloids are really important in industry. Like the computer chips that we have in our cell phones and our computers and our TVs, they come from certain types of metalloids. They come from silicon. Silicon chips that are in those structures, those are metalloids. Now, those seven are our metalloids. We're going to say everything here in red to the right of it. So all these guys here, all of these guys are our nonmetals. We're also going to say hydrogen over here, even though it's over here, it's also a nonmetal. So the ones in blue streaks are your metalloids. The ones that are in red are your nonmetals. Nonmetals tend to be brittle and dull in color. They don't conduct electricity. They don't insulate, they don't hold on to heat very well. These are the properties of nonmetals. We're also going to say that it seems like there's a lot fewer nonmetals because everything else that's not with blue streaks or not in red is considered a metal. So as you can see, there's a lot more metals in the periodic table than anything else. Metals tend to be shiny. They conduct electricity very well. These are the properties that we'll see with metals. They're very reflective. Gold, silver, platinum, these types of metals is what comes to mind.